My name is Nathan Palpant, and I'm a group leader at the Institute for Molecular Bioscience at the University of Queensland. My lab uses stem cells to study cardiovascular development and disease. My lab studies cardiovascular biology, and we're using methods to study how the heart develops, to understand that process, and use that as a way of informing strategies for therapeutic applications. So for example, we can understand the genes, the control points, shall we say, of how the heart develops. As my lab has grown, I've been intentional about bringing in bioinformaticians who can handle genomic data, cell biologists who can do stem cell differentiation, and also physiologists who can work with animals to try to build an interdisciplinary program.
My name is Enakshi Sinniah. I work at the Palpant Lab at the Institute for Molecular Biosciences at the University of Queensland. And my research focuses on the fundamental mechanisms that define cellular identity. It's the cutting edge of where stem cell biology and developmental biology meet bioinformatics. So a lot of the work we're doing is actually in collaboration with computational analysts. So we're looking at a lot of big data, data where we're looking at genomic wide information at the level of a single cell. So we're taking that data and actually trying to identify what defines the genetic soul of a cell.
When a person has a heart attack, their heart loses in billions of cells. Just within the process of losing blood flow to the heart, that causes an injury that ultimately results in heart failure. And so currently there are no standard of care approaches or pipeline drugs that actually help protect the acute injury response of the heart. And that is where we're focusing our efforts. We've actually worked with chemists that have been digging into spider venoms and being able to find proteins that are derived from venoms that actually create a protection against the heart when it has an ischemic event, like a heart attack, and even in a stroke. So this is a very exciting direction, and we're using our stem cells as a model of human heart muscle to also model that ischemic stress and try to develop this therapeutic. So I would never have imagined that I would be doing this kind of research. Even 5 years ago, I would never have imagined it. But it's really just this environment and making use of key collaborations, building those networks, and figuring out what are the biggest questions we can ask, and taking opportunities where they come. And so that's where it's been an exciting journey. And honestly, I don't know that I would have been able to do this anywhere else in the world.